Now we're getting to the essential character. Recall, we talked about essential character just a bit when we talked about the general rule of interpretation 3b. Here's our GRIs. So we have this essential character rule here, right? We also have essential character rule in 2. Essential character rule over here too, where we have unassembled products, right? So, as you can see, a lot of knowledge is really portable from classification to the country of origin provision to the free trade agreement. So going back to our free trade agreement outline, we actually have a better definition for the essential character. Because in the regulation, here we're talking about the 102.11, 102.18, 102.11, to be more precise, I think 102.11, let's double check. Because they are found here and there. So no, 102 is essential character, and 102.18 is the rule, is those rules of interpretation, right? And those rules of interpretation, they really break it down for us. So this is a very helpful provision for us to deal with, because unlike the GRIs, this regulation actually says what needs to be taken into account when trying to determine the essential character. Recall, the essential character usually is comprised of products here from various countries, right? Or which component within that product is most important component that drives the product determination with respect to classification, and in this case, with respect to North American Free Trade Agreement marking rules. So we have to know that those four materials have to be, those four components have to be taken into consideration, elements, if you will, elements. Bulk, quantity, weight, value. Bulk, quantity, weight, value, right? So those are the primary ones. And it has to be, of course, on a relative basis. So remember those buzzwords, bulk, quantity, weight, value. Because customs examiners have asked the following question in the past. Which one, so they give you this preamble because all the stuff is located in the annex. And annex is then incorporated in the Code of Federal Regulations, which found the relevant portion of which found its way into the 19 CFR 102.18, section 102.18, which we are talking about right now. So, which one of the following is not considered in determining essential character of the good? We know that the factors that we must take into account, bulk, quantity, weight, and value, are available. Bulk is not here. Value, weight, quantity here. They're all material in relation to its use, right? So everything is in relative perspective. So the only one that's not available is the color. And since we're looking for the one that's not, color is the right answer choice, making B a correct answer choice. So know the elements, bulk, quantity, weight, value, and know that it's in relationship to each other.